In 2022, the government announced a 5 billion shillings grant for elderly persons aged 60 to 79 years who are not beneficiaries of a social assistance grant for empowerment (SAGE) program, targeting over 1.8 million people. The fund is accessed as a grant in groups of 5 to 10 people, and each group is given 5 million shillings for ventures like farming, poultry, and others. However, legislators claim that the social enterprise grant for older persons is causing problems in their constituencies because the older persons have waited in vain.
How many people in Terego are earning this ego money? It is a time bomb for you. You are busy centralizing yourself with something small other than looking at the bigger picture. We are saying the SAGE money would cover the over 80 and plus who majority have not even got. Now, you want to click on SAGE, is it SAGO? Yet, it's a drop in the ocean. We have said we have not neglected this issue of SAGO. What we are saying is, can we look at the bigger picture?
MPs are fearing that the introduction of a social enterprise grant for older persons is a ploy to interfere with the social assistance grant for empowerment, which is also struggling.
The older people start from 60 years to onwards. And the big percentage are these ones who are not being catered for. Say 60 to 79. Because those who are 8 and above are few. That's why some of us who are dealing with old persons, we tried to look for a way. How can we bring this other group on board? Because it had been left out.
My grandmother, who is above 80, has not got anything. And you are still here on the issue of SAGO, which SAGO has never reached Terego. I'll ask the elderly people of Terego to look at you. The elderly people who are going to contest, who are only talking about SAGO, should first reach Terego.
Lawmakers on the Parliamentary Forum on Social Protection want the government to concentrate on the meager resources on the limping SAGE to reach more beneficiaries of 60 to 79 years who are currently locked out.
You know, our argument has been that we need to reduce the age for SAGE so that we can cover more people. But now, after introducing SAGO, it has become very difficult to reduce the age because you are going to be referred to SAGO. That those from 60 to 79 can benefit from SAGO, while the who are above 70 will now benefit from SAGE. But the challenge is that the money under SAGO is too small to cover everywhere.
Patrick Katabazi Chichoncho, an economic expert, has advised the government that it is not prudent to substitute SAGE with social enterprise grant for older persons, which is targeting less number of people and is not regular.
Technically speaking, it would be unwise to abandon the idea of reducing the age of eligibility so that each and every older person is covered and to opt for something very small. Because here it is a consistent social protection mechanism. Periodic, sustainable and predictable income flow to an older person.
However, Joy Wako Peggy, the national female representative of older persons, is in disagreement with fellow legislators, saying older persons need the two funds until the government will make a full rollout of SAGE up to the age of 60.
I was really touched, if not disappointed, when one of your own, moreover direct, stood up and said that he's not in support with this program, with this other program we have of SAGO. This forum is there to advocate for these vulnerable people.
Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.